Capitol Hill, we have Republican Senator from Pennsylvania and member of the Senate Budget Committee. You all will be releasing your own budget. Senator Pat Toomey, you call the president's budget, Senator, a failure of leadership. Why?
Well, Mika, it seems to me there's two big priorities that the budget ought to address. Number one is policies that maximize economic growth because we still have a very weak economy. And number two, putting us on a sustainable fiscal path because we are not on one now and we court great danger if we continue down this path. The president fails on both counts. Huge spending increases, an even bigger deficit next year than last year, does not solve the long-term debt problem. The tax increases would slow down economic growth. And he doesn't even address the biggest driver in our long-term deficit problem, which he has admitted is government health care spending, doesn't even address it in a meaningful, serious way. This is a complete abdication of leadership.
I'm going to follow up, and Chuck Todd, feel free to jump in, anyone here at the table as well. But how would the tax increases that he's talking about applying the Buffett rule slow down economic growth?
Well, first of all, he's taken the exact opposite approach of that of every commission that's looked at tax reform. What every bipartisan group has said we ought to do is simplify the code, broaden the base on which tax rates are applied, but apply lower tax rates because that encourages economic growth. What he's doing is he's calling for those rates to go higher. The second thing that's very damaging is to layer all of this tax that he wants to layer on investment, on capital gains and dividends. Do you know, as an owner of a business, your business pays tax, a corporate income tax that can be as high as 35%. And then the president wants any dividend that's paid to that owner to be then taxed at an additional rate of up to 40%, a combined 75% tax on investment. That's going to drive capital overseas. It's going to prevent investment in America. It's terrible economic policy.
Chuck Todd.
Senator Toomey, 6 months ago, you had a chance to strike a big deal with the president. Right. The president was talking about doing things on Social Security and Medicare and Medicaid that no Democratic president had ever talked about in the modern era since the creation of Medicare. And, you know, there was seemed to be some agreement on talking about tax reform in the way you talked about it, which was lowering rates, but possibly bringing in a little more revenue, depending on what parts of the tax code were eliminated. There was the shot there, and then everybody walked away. Why did you walk away?
Well, Chuck, I didn't walk away. You may recall I served on the super committee. And in the super committee, we heard a lot of talk from our colleagues on the other side, as we heard from the president, that they're willing to look at these entitlement programs. They're willing to have that discussion. It was a willingness for them to talk, but there was never a willingness to put a specific proposal on the table. And I actually did put a proposal on the table that reformed taxes, that simplified the code, lowered marginal rates, and generated more revenue. Something that I wasn't terribly comfortable with, something I don't think we ought to do, but I was willing to do it in order to get some kind of progress on the entitlement side. And in fact, the Democrats showed an initial interest, and then they walked away. Just very, very disappointing, and the president is showing that he has no intention of dealing with these, really the defining challenge of our time.
Dave Walker.
Senator, clearly the biggest problem is spending, and clearly we need to significantly reduce spending on a going forward basis, which involves social insurance reforms, defense and other spending reductions, et cetera. But we're also going to need more revenues. My question is will you and your party support comprehensive tax reform that broadens the base, that lowers rates, but that will generate more revenues as a percentage of GDP than the historical average of 18.4%? Because I can tell you, the math doesn't work otherwise.
Well, first of all, my preference would be to have a smaller government where we could get by with 18 and a half, our historical level. But I acknowledge, given the demographics and given where we are politically, very, very tough to get there. What I've said is, let's have the simplification. Let's reform the code. Let's lower marginal rates. And you know what? In the end, that may very well produce higher than 18.5% of GDP revenue. And I've never said if it does, we suddenly have to toss that. I think. Let's get the code right. Let's get the structure right. Let's make it maximize economic growth. And you know, we might find that it generates more revenue than 18.5%.
Follow up. The Senate hasn't passed a budget in over 1,000 days. Are we going to get one this year? And if not, will the Republicans on the Senate Budget Committee offer their own proposal?
Republicans will be voting on a budget that Republicans support. I can promise you that. It may be the House Republican budget. It may be our own budget. We may have several budgets as we did last year. And you know, you don't have to agree with everything that's in the Republican budget, obviously, but you have to acknowledge that one party in this town actually produced a budget that they believe in, that they were willing to stand for. The Democrats have absolutely refused, and Harry Reid so far has said this will be another year where they will ignore their statutory obligation and an obligation based on decency to do a budget. So I hope Harry will change his mind, but there's no evidence of that so far.
All right, Senator Pat Toomey, thank you very much.
Thanks for having me.
Chuck Todd, before you go,